the DC suits on hand, and we had a hard time, but we tried to understand these born again gunpoint libertines.
Now I wanted to talk to you about How's Your News, because I know that there's some stuff happening with that, and I was wondering if, for the folks out there who may not know anything about it, if you could kind of fill them in. And then I know it's actually becoming a series that's getting ready to launch, so I was wondering if you could expand on that for us.
Yeah, How's Your News is a program, a news program that is sort of presenting a news conventional setup with a news show is slightly altered, and one of the reasons it is a little bit different is that the reporters all have different disabilities, and so it's sort of breaking down some of those barriers in which you don't necessarily, people aren't used to seeing people with disabilities with a microphone sort of in interviewing others. It's a relatively new concept, and you get some really sort of sublime interactions though when it sort of breaks down some of the walls that people put up. It manages some of the
all the sound bites don't work so well anymore, you know.
It's different. It just changes it so that there's just more truth in it than maybe a conventional news show. But it's a lot of things too. It's like there's a How's Your News band, and there's always a lot of singing, and we go to like alligator farms and the conventions and prison rodeos and just sort of get the scoop.
State radio shows.
Nice.
Yeah, they come out and blow us off the stage.
Now, how did you guys come up with this concept? Because you've had it in the works for a long time.
Yeah, we've been doing it for about 10 years. It started off as a camp, like maybe like 14 years ago. There's a camp in Martha's Vineyard in Massachusetts where there's it's a camp for adults with disabilities, and I started hanging out there when I was 16, just sort of helping out. And we used to make small films, and it just sort of grew from that. And now we sort of stopped. We stopped doing it a couple years ago, and then MTV, because we ran out of money basically, and then MTV came along, was like, I don't know how it got into their hands, but they were like, we'd like to see more of this. And so now we just finished 6 episodes. So it was fun, you know, climbing a mountain, going to New Orleans, California, just sort of doing quirky, fun things.
Nice. So is it going to be airing on MTV then?
Yeah, in November.
Fantastic. Now, I understand Matt Stone and Trey Parker were involved in the beginnings of this. Is that accurate?
Or? Yeah. Yeah. We made one film. They originally saw some of the early films, and they gave us money to, with like no strings attached, back in like 98 to do a feature film. So we did that in 99, a cross-country trip, sort of like How's Your News from the Atlantic to the Pacific. And because of them, they've been awesome all along. They've been executive producers, but have just sort of let us do whatever we want. I think part of the reason MTV was really, we actually got the MTV. We did a pilot to see if MTV would be into it, and they were. And part of the reason we think they're into it is because MTV was dying to work with Matt and Trey, and they had never really worked together. So I think they've definitely helped grease some of those wheels. But they're great guys, you know, just like they get it. And, you know, they have an interesting reputation, but I think, you know, they've been nothing but just like really sweet guys and really encouraging of the whole project.
Awesome. Well, what else do you guys have going on this summer? I know you said you're headed to San Diego next. Where does the tour go from there?
Up the West Coast, and then do a couple of shows in the middle of the country, and then make it back to Boston. Where we're doing a Bikes Not Bombs show, which should be pretty cool. We all get to ride bikes for the show with a bunch of people. So we'll see if we can still ride bikes. And then and then hopefully the DNC and the RNC, we can get involved in that. And
that'd be great, right here in Denver.
Make some noise.
Right.
Yeah,
we'll be back,
look forward hopefully. To seeing you here for that, definitely.
Yeah.
So nothing you can do is gonna make me stay. You gotta let others have their glory in day. Cause you know the whole time getting together Leland's born. Everyone's getting their nice shoes on. Girls are all cutting off their confirmation dresses. Streets will be empty tomorrow. The whole town confesses in the bar.